Hello and welcome everybody. How are you today? So we're just going to open up the Facebook Live as well. So welcome all you YouTubers. Welcome all you Facebook Ubers. So how is everyone? Can you hear us? Are we loud? Coming out loud and clear?
Can you see us? Can you hear us?
We've got Anne from Scunthorpe in North Lincolnshire. We've got Ian. What do you mean about the music? That was a great song. We've got Cheryl from Harrow. Oh, not too far from us. So welcome one more time. Shall I put the flags away?
Welcome to our V-Day street party.
Yeah, I think we've got a special event planned today.
We do.
Got a bit of chit-chat coming up. I'm going to give you a little bit of history and talk about some musicality. Well, you could never accuse me of talking too much. Well, at least I wouldn't. So we're going to start with the... classes as we do, but if you've got any questions, you can send me. We've actually had a couple of questions sent in, so it's going to be quite an action-packed program. We're going to start. Well, we thought we did the Lambeth Walk last week, and we know you all know it. So we thought this week we could do a Big Apple to thank our American cousins who came over during the Second World War, and they brought with them this dance called the Big Apple. So I think we're going to start with that.
Everyone get up, let's get warmed up, and let's in do the it. Mood.
Now, don't panic, this is not the fast choreographed version. This is the social one that we can all do at a good old tea dance with your cup of teas at the ready. Right. Here we go. The first thing we do is we imagine we're in a big circle, because it's the Big Apple, and we are the core of the apple, because you can hear me calling out. Hopefully you can hear me. We're going to hold on to our partner if you've got one, or otherwise imaginary partner either side of us, big circle, right in the middle, and we tap. One, two, three, four. We call this marking time. Now, pat your foot, not the dog, just pat the foot. A one, a two, swing it now. So when I shout swing it, we go into a Charleston step. We go back on the right foot, tap the left toe behind, forward on the left, tap the right toe in front. And repeat, touch, step, touch, step, touch. Here we go, step, touch, swing those arms. Everybody now, swing the arms, gonna warm us up for an evening. Gonna do lots and lots of steps. Have you put your Fitbit on? Check, you know how many steps you're gonna do tonight. We're having a competition. I'm gonna see if I can do more than the rest of you put together. And we go, step, touch, step, touch. That's the first step. So it's called our Charleston. So one more time from the top. We go tap, two, swing it. Now we go back, back, forward and swing. We go back, back. Now when I shout stomp, apple stomp, throw the right leg on the floor, stomp it down and arms up in the air. Back, back, forward and stomp. Back, back, forward and stomp. And then of course we've got the pump handle. Now this is one of my favorites. As we go forward, we kick the right leg in the air twice. So we go back, back, forward and double. Back, back, forward and double. Now, at the same time as you pump the leg, you pump the arm. So you go double, back, back, forward and double. Back, back, forward and double. The same time as you pump the leg and you pump the arms, you also shout, wahoo! Back, back, forward and...
wahoo!
Can't hear you out there, a bit louder. Wahoo! Back, really loud, you can do it. And wahoo! Back, back, forward and wahoo! That's called the pump handle. What's it called?
Pump handle!
Pump handle, excellent. Right, from the tippity-tippity top, we're in a big circle, imagine the circle, and the core of the apple shouts, marking time, a one, a two, a swing it. Now we go back, back, forward and swing. Back, back, forward and swing. Apple stomp. Back, back, forward and stomp. Pump handle, ready? Wahoo! Back, back, forward and wahoo! Now, I might shout truck to the right. So you turn to your right, which is actually, let's turn to our left and then it's your right.
Yeah, we'll go around.
Okay, so you truck to the right. You put one finger in there, you shake it like you're telling somebody off, and you go. A step, hop, step, hop, step, hop, step. A one, two, three, and round in a circle. Truck to the right. And reverse, you turn and put the left hand up and go back the other way. A one, two, three, four, truck to the left. Two, three, four, five, sit down. We sometimes do a bit of call and response. So we'll give you an example. I will do the call and Anna will do the response. But you have to be Anna in a second. So let's truck to the right. A truck on down.
Yeah, yeah.
A truck on down.
Yeah, yeah.
And reverse. A truck on high.
Yeah, yeah.
A truck on high.
Yeah, yeah.
And truck on down.
Yeah, yeah.
A truck on down.
Yeah, yeah.
Were you all joining in? I hope it's not just us. Right.
I hope it's not just me.
Now, let me see. What can we do next? We could have a rusty dusty.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, rusty dusty. So, grab hold of your trousers, shake the dust out. If you haven't got trousers, maybe you've got a skirt. Not too high, ladies, please. We don't want to see those stocking tops quite this early on in the evening. Not till we've had a cup of tea, at least. So we grab the stocking tops, and we go into the middle of the circle. A one, two, three, four. And we go back out. A five, six, seven, eight. You turn to your partner. One, two, three, four. And back out. Five, six, seven, eight. You turn to the dog, the couch, the chair, the person on the other side of you. A one, two, three, four. And back out. A five, six, seven, eight. That's called rusty dusty. What's it called?
Rusty, Dusty.
Okay, together we go. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then we might have Susie Q to the right. We can do a very easy Susie Q. It's called Susie with a drop. Clasp the hands together and go. A 1, 2, 3, and reverse. 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 That's Susie with a drop. What's it called?
Susie with a drop.
That's it. Named after drop. That's right. Now, what else have we got? I think we should have a fun move. What were you going to say? The wiggle. This is Anna's favourite. Get ready for this. Give us a wiggle, Anna.
Here we go. Wiggle.
Do we all have
to
do that?
We do. Okay. You wiggle everything. You wiggle the shoulder, the head, the hips, everything.
Let's have a quick practice. Wiggle the shoulders. Wiggle the hips. Wiggle the head. Okay, ready? And jump. And wiggle. One more time, the wiggle. Now, you might think this is a very silly dance, but it was actually a very popular dance from about 1936, 37, and 38, it spread everywhere. So it's a really popular dance, and I'm sure those GIs would have been doing a big apple when they came over here to our street parties. Swingaroo.
Swingaroo.
Right arm and right arm.
You might recognise this from the Lambeth Walk.
Truck around. A 1, 2, 3, and reverse. A 1, 2, 3, and reverse. A 1, 2, 3, and reverse. A 1, 2, 3, back to the basic. And so whenever we finish a variation, we can always go back to our basic Charleston or continue the last move that we did. So if I don't say anything, you just keep going. I think we should do which one?
Birdie in a cage.
Birdie in a cage. Okay. So, one person gets down.
There's my birdie.
And what do you do, Anna?
I hold the cage and truck around. 1, 2, 3.
Birdie in a cage. And reverse. So this time, Anna will go down. I hold onto the cage. Watch and I truck around. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Now you can find your own style. You might want to swivel around, that's fine too. You might want to show your socks as you go around, do a little shag step. So you find your way of doing birdie in a cage.
We haven't seen your socks.
Yeah, I just showed my socks.
Nice socks.
Well, I've got to have a bit of colour somewhere. Right, are we ready?
We're ready.
Let's do a big apple. Let's get some music.
Just double check that everyone can hear us and see
us. Give us a quick sign. Can you hear us? We've got Margarita, welcome back.
Hello,
thank you.
Welcome back.
Nice to see you. We've got Melissa, bonjour. We've got Ian, we've seen. And we've got some people, quite a few people on Facebook Live, actually. Fantastic.
Hello, everyone.
Right, there's a wave there. Fantastic. Who have we got? We've got Hans, we've got Carol, we've got Ruth. Excellent job. Right, here we go. Let's find, we've got to just get the band organised. So we're going to have a bit of a party now. So everybody up, let's do some dancing and burn off all those calories for all the cakes that we're going to be eating in a minute. Have you got your cakes ready? Because it's a street party.
It's a scones party.
Actually, Anna's been baking all day. She's just, you know, seriously into baking. For the last 3 days, she put all her ration coupons together and just baked and baked and baked. Right, here we go. The Big Apple. Up and tuck. Five, six, swing it now. We go back, back, forward and forward. And stop. This time, give me a double. Truck high, and reverse. head to the right.
Call the steps we ought to
reverse.
Shall we truck off Susie Q?
Reverse.
Or swing it high.
Rusty Dusty.
Big apple.
To your partner.
Big apple.
To the person on the other side.
Leave your man for us.
Swing your room.
While we circle round the floor. Shall we do the dance?
Reverse.
Or reverse it. Praise
Allah,
wiggle,
praise Allah,
wiggle,
wiggle
and dance,
praise Allah, wiggle,
and sweet romance,
truck,
big apple, big apple,
and reverse,
leader men, we've heard them brag, about the steps,
now put in a cage,
but this dance is in the bag, big apple,
reverse. Now, did you do the warm-up with us?
Oops, sorry.
Oops, sorry.
Too many flowers.
Too many flowers. Oh, yeah, you've got quite a selection of flowers there. I noticed there's a theme going on, but we'll come back to that later, yeah. So, it's time for the classes. Now, that means some of you may want to disappear, or you may have already had enough of the Big Apple. You may want to disappear, and you may want to look at the classes. We put them up on YouTube. There's a link. Always the link if they're on Facebook.
Well, good question. If you're on Facebook, you want to head to YouTube, youtube.com/SwingdanceUK. And that's where you can find our beginners and intermediate class of the day and even more classes if you wish.
Good. And people on Montpellier, Gilbert. Bonjour, ça va?
Bonjour, bonjour. Bonsoir, plutôt.
And we've got Leah now. We are going to be here. We're going to show you quickly what's going to go on in the classes, because if you don't watch them now, you can watch them later. They're up on YouTube and they're free. Mm-hmm. But who else have we got on?
We've got Steve's connected. Hi, Steve.
Hi, Steve.
And Ruth as well. Ruth. Hello to you both.
Louise.
Louise watching.
Excellent.
David as well. Jim. Janet.
Wow.
Yvonne, Loren, wow, excellent, fantastic.
Jonathan, just round the corner from us, I believe.
Oh, yes, that's right.
Fantastic. Okay, well, I hope you're going to be up dancing. So this is what
we'll
did at the beginners.
We'll come and check through the window. Oh, yes, so, we have to show you what we did in the classes.
So we'll show you what we did in the classes. So in the beginners class, it was a big one.
Mm.
Not a lot of variety, but probably one of the most important moves. You do the Lindy turn. So we did our Lindy turn. But then we added some styling for the beginners. So for the follows.
Classic settings, swivels.
And for the leaders, hang out and. I don't know if they can see this on Facebook. So I did a layout or a hangout, just hanging out, trying not to kick the cat or the dog behind me. Right, that was the beginners. Now what did we do in the intermediates? Can you remember?
Good question. What did we do? We started with a circle.
I know we did a circle. Oh, and then we did the over the tops.
Oh, yes, we did.
So we did intermediate class, we did this. Circle. Over the tops. Johnny's drop. And then we did hacksaw kicks. And exit. So that was the intermediate class. So if you want to learn either the Lindy turn or the hacksaw kicks and the over the tops, then head over to YouTube. But come back to us for 8 o'clock. If you are not going to learn those steps because you know them already, or you think you'll look at them later, then you can stay with us and have a chat with us and the dance. I see Frank from Germany. Great to see you, Frank. I've seen some nice pictures of you on YouTube recently. I think you're from the 80s next to some really cool cars. That's great. We've got Lisa as well. We've got Martin. So great, fantastic. Who have we got on YouTube?
We've got Catherine is back and Sarah's way. Sarah as
fantastic.
Well, sorry.
Okay, I'm going to play one of my records actually.
Oh.
I've decided we're going to have a bit of a battle of the blues for this first song. We're going to have Big Mouth Gal. Now, this is nothing to do with Anna, I just got to say. But if you want to hold up...
Right, I'll show it to Facebook.
I'll get the record on. So get the old vinyl out.
Battle of the Blues.
Oops.
It does look like me, the one who's punching the other.
Yes. With your boxing gloves. Actually, I'm just going to... a bit of...
Is it fiddly?
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Fiddly.
It's not in the best position. I should change it, really. I keep saying that every week. That's my excuse. Here we go. Battle of the Blues. And feel free to have a little boogie, either on your own or with your partner. Have we got any more volume?
I think we do. Is that all right?
From my album, The Battle of the Blues. Ah, that was called Big Mouth Gal by Mr. Vincent. Right, oh, well, that warmed us up. I don't know about you guys. So who's been dancing out there? Tell us if you've been dancing. And let's see. So, oh, right, I'm out of breath.
What do you have next, Maestro?
What do I have next? Okay. Well, we're actually going to go to a little... I just was in the mood for a bit of R&B, so we're going to go a little bit of Hogwash. So Hogwash, everybody, and let's do a bit of Louis Jordan before we come back together at 8 o'clock when we have lots of interesting things, a little bit of history coming up, and a little bit of musicality. Somebody asked a question last week. We have the answer this week.
Every year about 4:30, we all go down to the old town hall, and all night long we have a ball at the Hogwash Junction function. Last year we took ethyl gasoline and added some ketchup and kerosene and mixed it up in the washing machine at the Hogwash Junction function. I had a gossip all night with Susie Brown.
And
the old
you know what to do, get up and dance.
Jake and Jim had to have a fight. It didn't make no difference, we rocked all night. Everybody flipped when Jill told Jack, I'm flying to Mars on the Duncan's back. She was tight as an oyster in a crocus sack at the Hogwash Junction function. Thank you.
Jordan, you hear him so much that sometimes you forget to play him. But the reason you hear him so much is because, one, he was very prolific, but two, he was very good. You know, he used to play with Chick Webb.
He
had a good pedigree. Right. Who else has joined us?
Ryan is online on Facebook. And John as well, as was host.
Okay, so somebody on YouTube, Sarah, has said, watching on Facebook. So you're watching us in stereo. Excellent. You can hear us on both sides. I'm impressed. We've got some people lagging. Stream's lagging.
Maybe why she might have swapped to Facebook.
And then somebody else says, Katrina said, sound is perfect, but my stream is really lagging. Maybe it's just my connection. Do you have that problem all the time, or is it just us?
Right, the door.
Right. Somebody's come round. Somebody's come round for a dance. No, so I'll have to keep talking. Okay, so, right, is it 8 o'clock yet? We've got Chris. Hi, Chris, nice to see you. It's been a while. We've got Mila, Harris, fantastic, and we've got Ingrid. Wow, we've got a nice crowd today. So let me know, has anyone else put their Fitbit on? So I've made a note of how many steps I've done, because we want to do lots and lots and lots of steps tonight to keep us fit and healthy. Have you been going out for walks? I've actually been doing more walking than I normally do. I don't think I put any petrol in my car since the lockdown started. So I've just been walking everywhere, really. I hope my car still starts. Battery's probably gone flat, to be honest. But there we go. Right, let's see. We're going to have... we've got time for one more song. Before we start the show proper at 8 o'clock. So let's do a little bit of something different this time. Let's go for some a little bit more Charleston-y, the Savoy Orpheans. It's an English band, used to play at the Savoy, very posh, very posh. The Savoy Orpheans. Now, if you haven't got a partner, you can still dance. Thank you.
nigga where the gang goes. When I take my sugar tip, yeah. Well, I'm a rough bitch out of that sea. She's a high half baby, that she. And I never take her where the gang goes. When I take my sugar tip, yeah. Every Sunday afternoon, we forget about our care. Rubbing elbows at the wrist with the visionaire. When I take my sugar beauty, I'm as busy as I can be. Cause I never take her where the gang goes. When I take my sugar beauty.
So, welcome back, yes. Everybody. If you just come back from the classes, Anna, what have you got there?
I have got to apologise for leaving you halfway through the show. The doorbell rang.
Smells very nice. Can you smell them?
Extra flowers, new flowers, just in time for our V-Day street party.
Fantastic.
Isn't that lovely? So, it's going to look more like a street.
Excellent. Well, so we've got some flowers, and the room smells so nice. As I said, I don't know about you guys, but we've been doing lots and lots of walking, and it's been absolutely fantastic to get out in the greenery of life.
Yes.
Have I set that camera quite right? Now, some people are saying there's
Fatima's
online.
Hello,
no lag on Facebook. Who is that?
Lisa Fatima.
Fatima, hey!
And Catherine has joined us on Facebook, hopping between YouTube and Facebook. And
Major Cliff, Jonathan, Jordan, well done. Thank you. Thank you all so much for coming down. So today's theme is our V-Day street party. Last
it's
week...
It's almost a garden party now.
It is a garden party.
But could you tell the theme? I mean, are there any clues around here?
Last week, we talked the Lambeth Walk.
Mm-hmm.
And some people were asking a little bit about the history of the Lambeth Walk. And it was originally in a show with Lupino Lane in 1937.
Mm-hmm.
But it had a revival, I read, during the Second World War, about 1944, and it was a dance that did travel. It was one that travelled from England across to America, and in fact all over Europe.
Yeah.
And there are so many versions. I've got some wonderful versions. A bit later, I think I'm going to play the Artie Shaw version I've got of the Lambeth Walk. Duke Ellington did it. Everyone was doing the Lambeth Walk.
Even in Germany, they were doing the Lambeth Walk. I don't know how popular that was there for the government, but they did the Lambeth Walk there as well.
Yes, I don't think it went everywhere. Now, I see you've got a nice cup of tea here, Anna. That's very, very positive. When you want to top
tea
up.
Pot. Oh, yes, thank you.
Have a top up. Fantastic. And you've got some biscuits. Well, we'll tuck into those a bit later. Now, we had a question that I wanted to address, first of all. So let me just find the question. And perhaps, Anna, you could... reply, you could read that for me.
All right, so it's a question from Mike, who's asking, just wondering what came of your apparently brief introduction to ballroom. I'm finding it tough. And I'm also wondering whether you and Anna tap dance. Oh dear.
Right, so two questions. Mm. In answer to the first one, I wrote in my swing notes this week, I told people how I went to three classes of ballroom. And then the teacher decided to do a rock and roll course. This was back in 1982. So after that rock and roll course, I never really went back to the ballroom. However, I did dabble now and then by having the odd class or meeting. I got to work with some actually top professional ballroom dancers on a couple of occasions, and that mm-hmm. was fun. I got to do some research for a TV show where they wanted to know how people danced the foxtrot in England in the sort of 30s, early 40s. Mm-hmm. So I went to a lot of tea dances that were on in the afternoon at the Opera House at various different venues. And I met lots of older generation dancers, and I was asking them all sorts of questions. I was interviewing them, and and asking them how they used to dance. And it was quite interesting. Quite a few of them were very proud with the fact they'd never had a dance lesson in their whole life. Now, in truth, in fairness, you could tell by the way they were dancing. There were a couple of people out there who were doing competition-style ballroom, and it did look so fake and unreal. But the interesting thing is, whilst you wouldn't say they were great dancers, these people have been dancing for 50 years and having fun every week for the last 50 years. And I think that's really what dancing is all about.
Social dancing, yeah. Can what
you,
dancing?
I don't know if you can hear, but we have an airport not too far from us. We don't often get the planes flying over us. It's quite rare.
Yeah, especially at the moment.
But sometimes, because it's an RAF base, sometimes they have things like Spitfires. And I've seen a lot of propeller planes.
Do you think they've sent some Spitfires, especially for us, for the V-Day party?
I do. I think they have.
That's wonderful.
Oh, my gosh. We've got Jenna. How are you? Jenna, great to see you. Oh. It's been a long time. And the family.
And Christine is watching. Hi,
and
Chris.
Christine and Warren, excellent.
Warren,
nice to see you all, guys.
Fantastic.
Okay. I think it's time for a little bit more music. Let's see. Well, I think I played this not too long ago, but I do like it. And it's sort of quite appropriate. So I'm going to take you doing the jive with Major Glenn Miller. Doing the jive. And Glenn Miller. It's such a great song. You've got to dance to this one.
As soon as it's playing. Here we go.
Doing the jive, Mr. Glenn Miller, were you all up jiving? That's what I want to know. I actually wonder, this is my own theory, I've not heard this before, maybe somebody out there will know. We don't know exactly how the dance got called jive in the UK. Now, some people say it was to do with the Callaway jive slang, the Harlem slang, Slim Gaylord. You know, they say, don't jive me, man. give me five, you know. There was that slang, and they used the word jive, as in talk, as in don't jive me. However, I wonder with that song if that was a novelty dance and they were trying to create a little dance based around that song.
Yeah,
and that maybe how that got known as the jive. I don't know. Anyone else out there know? Maybe somebody remembers. So let us know. Who else have we got with us?
Oh. We've got Alison. So we've got Chris and Alison. Both are joining us. We met them on the cruise this January, which was
fantastic.
A first experience. It's great to see you again. And
Stephen?
Steve and Chris are here and they're enjoying the track.
Yeah, we did go on a very nice cruise, actually.
Hi, Jaylene.
Apart from the 2 days when the boat was rocking and rolling and we were trying to teach dance.
Yes.
We were trying to teach like this. Oh, run this way, run that way. Anyway, second part of the question was, do we tap dance? Well, I was very lucky.
I'll change
the basic step. But I'm not a tap dancer. But I have learned some tap dance. I was lucky I spent a year and a half with the lovely Rusty Frank, who's a very good teacher. And I've had a few classes. Actually, to be honest, I've had some classes with some very good teachers, whether it was in Harang with Chaz or whether it was in one time, actually, Gregory Hines was in London and he did a class, free class at the
South Bank Centre,
Royal Festival Hall. And I stood in the back and got totally out of my depth. But I just pitter-pattered away. And the funniest thing was, he was such a lovely guy. And a week later, I was in New York. And I was staying with my friend Cynthia. Hello, Cynthia, if you're there. I was staying with Cynthia. And in her, she was the trendy part, uptown, downtown, wherever. Anyway, so I was in a local supermarket, a little corner store, you know, really quite tiny. And I saw this guy and I thought, gosh, he's a bit scruffy looking, hasn't shaved much, and he's in a long coat, but looks like Gregory Hines. And I said, were you just in London? And he said, yeah. And I said, oh, I saw you. I went to your class. So we had a little chat. He was very, very, very nice. Yeah, what are the odds of that?
Amazing.
That was quite cool. Anyway, do I tap dance? I can do a time step, which I will show you now.
Okay, demonstration. We won through.
And that's about all I remember. No, actually, I can do a few steps. I can't really tap dance. There are a couple of clips of me and Rusty tapping. Luckily, she's a loud tap dancer, so my taps get a little bit lost, but it looks good. We did lots of arms, the Nicholas Brother arms. That was my...
All about the show.
It's all about the show, and that's the best way, because it is tap dancing.
Yes.
So I'm not a tapper, I'm not a tap dancer, but I can do a couple of steps. Mm.
I've seen you join
in
the tap jam once, though.
I can fake a few basics.
I liked it because I love watching tap. I can't tap, it's on my bucket list. I'd love to learn. But I love watching tap. I've taken one tap class in my whole life. And Simon took me to the tap jam in London, which is fantastic. It's really spontaneous
and vibrant.
It was a
particularly good night, that one,
wasn't it?
It was
a brilliant night because Heather Cornell was in town.
Yeah, the lovely Heather Cornell.
Who was the teacher I had one class from. but Simon entered the tap jam and you just put it all your performance tricks, all the faces, all the swing attitude. And maybe, I don't know, I can't tell, you weren't probably the fanciest tapper. They enjoyed it because you had all the show faces.
Yeah, I did actually a lot of authentic jazz more than tap.
Yeah.
And I added a couple of pitter-patters in there.
All
I just
about
see
being different,
we've got
isn't it?
Anders from Sweden, I believe. Welcome, Anders. Great to see you. So quite a few people there. So hi, Anders. And who else have we got? We've got Freya and we've got Derek. Now, Derek also asked a question, and I'm going to be answering that a bit later. But right now, it's time for our sort of solo jazz section, because I know that not everyone in lockdown has a dance partner. Mm. Some of us do, so we're very lucky and we appreciate that. But if you don't, this next song is for you, because it's all about solo dance. It's a sort of, it's not quite Charleston, it's not quite Lindy, it's sort of in between. I've got two songs, actually. We've got Wolverine Blues and Zero with Louis Prima. But I think you can do some jazz to it. So more than Charleston, maybe a bit of jazz. So everybody, get those dancing shoes on. And if you haven't got dancing shoes on, dance around in your socks. Exercise today, that's good. I hope you are too. I saw a very long message. I don't know if you can go back, but somebody sent us a very long message.
Yes, Glenn. Loving the red, white, and blue guys. Oh, you got the memo.
You noticed.
I even got the earrings out. I think it's maybe attached too much. Oh, sorry. Sorry, YouTube.
And your flowers.
And the flowers.
And the flowers we had delivered.
And the flowers we had delivered, yes.
I see a little bit of white, and I see purple. So it's almost
close enough.
And we've got our flags up. Unfortunately, I didn't have an American flag. I do apologise, but I had an American tie. I don't know if they can see that on Facebook, but there's an American-looking tie. And do you know the funny thing is, I bought that years ago, years and years and years ago, and I don't think I've actually ever worn it. but I thought it looked fun because I thought it matched this one, you see. And to be honest, I don't wear this one a lot.
Same for me.
I think this might be the first time. But there we go.
And this is my best attempt of trying to get UK citizenship without having to pass all the tests where I need to know all the football games and who won when.
Now, Derek is asking about his question.
Wait, I haven't finished Glenn's message.
Oh, sorry.
So, Glenn likes the theme, but also he said, you inspired me to take a solo social distancing chatting class from my village outside of our decorated village hall. That's fantastic. Excellent.
Fantastic.
We can all dance even apart.
Oh, did I see Joe? Was that Joe Dunford?
Oh, yes. Joe, hi, Joe.
Joe, hi, Joe. From Cahoots. One of our favourite places to go when we go dancing.
Absolutely. And we were meant to be dancing for Cahoots on V-Day, weren't we?
Yes.
We were supposed to have a street party with Cahoots. So, next year. And
or maybe later this year. Who knows? And if you've not been there, they've got a new ticket office.
Oh, it's wonderful. It's absolutely fabulous. Also, if you like cocktails, this is the place to go.
Yes. And also socks. They did very good socks.
They've got the best socks.
But I haven't got them on today. I do apologise. Right. So the question was, where did the triple step come from? And that was from Derek. And now, I sort of wasn't too sure. And I said, well, I think it was the following the music. And in fact, I had a chat with a friend of mine called Al Nichols. Now, Al Nichols, you may know from a band called Blue Harlem. He's actually played with rather a few good names. He's played with Ray Gelato, King Pleasure and the Biscuit Boys, the Big Town Playboys. So he knows a little thing or two about the music. And he was talking, he was telling me about the roots of good pop music is the 4-4 pulse of swing music, which makes it good for dancing. A simple, catchy melody, just like a melody. Oh, no, that's not right. It's something that is easy to interpret what you hear. So you don't want anything too complicated. You don't want fussy melodies. So he suggested songs like Stomp at the Savoy and Easy Does It. Simple melodies, but very good for dancing because we can follow it, us non-dancers, us non-musicians, I should say. And then the music spells out rock step, triple step. And he was telling me, and this is what I didn't really know, that most modern pop music before swing was 4 beats to the bar, but prior to swing music, the notes were split evenly, such as in ragtime, I believe. And then with the swing and the jazz, they got split into 3 with the syncopation, and that really is the triple step was following the music. So that's why a triple step works very well. Derek, I hope that answers your question. I hope I did Al Nichols justice in my interpretation of what he said. I did actually an interview with him, and I will be writing a little bit more from Al in a future swing notes. So maybe worth checking out. I did one last week, 2 weeks ago, about the jive aces, and I thought, well,
it was really interesting.
I've known those guys for so long. I've known them since the late 80s, and I learned so much about them. And it's fascinating.
About their dance careers in particular.
Yes, and that was great. Who else have we got? So that hopefully...
answers Derek's question.
That answers Derek's question. Okay.
Go back to Derek.
I think it's time for a little bit more music. This time I thought we'd go for some Amos Milburn, and I thought we'd go to the... Do you want to hold that up?
Oh, Anna, thank
you.
Certainly.
I thought we'd go for the Chicken Shack Boogie. So this is bringing out the old records, the old vinyl. So here we go. Chicken Shack Boogie. Look at that. Cueing perfect. Spot on. Oh, yeah. Let's dance.
Chicken Shack.
I mastered stopping the vinyl.
Fantastic. I have a question for you, Anna.
For me?
Yeah, I just popped outside and I just happened to notice there's about 2 tons of earth in the lounge. I know you bought a few little flowers, but what's all the earth about?
Well, I just thought I'd order a bit of compost to improve the garden. We've spent so much time in the garden. I thought we needed a little extra.
A little bit of compost. So I guess I've got my work cut out then. I'll be doing a little bit of gardening over the next few days. Well, I hope the weather comes back. Have you been enjoying this amazing weather? It's been absolutely wonderful. What's this, Stephen Walker? What does he say?
He's remembering 25 years from the event in Favida in Hyde Park. Funnily enough, who was it who remembered it the other day?
Lisa Batum.
Lisa,
and
yes.
A few other people.
Still remember the Stoms doing the Charleston show. Oh, brilliant.
Fantastic.
I don't remember it.
I've got to tell you. That was an event. It was the 50th anniversary of V-Day. And I got contacted by the association, it was the official, it was part of the official celebrations. Mm-hmm. It was televised on BBC and it was in Hyde Park. They had a big dance floor. We had 400 people. We had 400 people on the dance floor. We had more people dancing around the edge. Mm-hmm. And then we had about 3-4 times that number of people just sitting around watching. It was a lovely hot day. And it was quite, at the time, 25 years ago, it was quite a major dance event, really. Yeah. There was music and dancing. And then afterwards, we stayed in Hyde Park and we did a bit of improvised dancing. But being part of the official celebration was pretty cool. So
well,
Stephen remembers that.
It's interesting because he said he first danced swing at this event. And Lisa was saying she was new and it really... it's a great memory for her because she realised what the dance meant and where it came from that day. So that obviously marked spirit.
In fact, that's quite interesting. If anyone wants to let us know, where did you first come across this dance or what made it special? Yeah, okay, you might have seen the dance, but what made you, because I'm guessing you're watching this if you're in love with the dance like us, what made you fall in love with the dance? What made it... really special for you. That'll be quite interesting to hear. Right, I'm going to get the next record on, but you need to pop next door and get the JAM. Don't tell everybody. Now, we happen to have...
We're casually out.
It's that time. It's that time of the evening. We do it every week when we have... Well, I've got to wait for Anna to come back. When we have a special event... just before we go into the Shim Sham. So we'll be doing the Shim Sham shortly. The Shim Sham shimmy, Shim Sham shimmy. And
Derek.
What have you got? This is for you, Derek, because we know it's your birthday. So here is the birthday jam for Derek. Yay! Now, this means everyone in the room has to dance with Derek.
Mm-hmm.
And if it's anyone else's birthday, you have to dance with everyone else in the room as well. So, Lucien's watching. Hi, Lucien.
Lucien's here.
Nice
to see you. Gary,
hello. Gary, excellent. So, this is a birthday jam. Now, I thought, we're having a tea party. We haven't had our biscuits yet. They're going to get cold. we're having a tea party. So, what could we play that's appropriate, a little bit of a different birthday song?
Something special for Derek.
So, yeah, and I thought, what does he like? Well, he likes pie.
Mm-hmm.
And he likes cake.
He does.
So I thought, what could we play?
He likes special your ties as well.
Now, Derek, this is for you. I like pie. I like cake. Now, remember, you have to dance with everybody in the room. So it's going to be, I'm going to be you, Derek. And Anna is going to be everybody else in the room. And she's going to be everybody dancing with me. So let's see how many sides of Anna there really are. Right. I like pie, I like cake. This is for you, Derek. Happy birthday. Woo!
Happy birthday.
And I bet you've got a big cake with candles mm-hmm. right now.
Can count on Jane to celebrate properly. Come on, birthday boy.
I like you better all, yeah, yeah.
Sham, Shimmy and Derek's birthday jam. Was it anyone else's birthday? Merci. Happy birthday. Oh, people are sending Derek birthday wishes. I went to see Kit Pack and Play and then to the classes to learn Lindy Hop. Wow, well done, Anne. I remember we used to have Kit Pack and Play for us at the Stompin', Monday night Stompin' at the 100 Club. Kit, if you're there, welcome. And Elle says, I really fell in love with Lindy in Harangue. What better place? Fantastic. That's the way to do it, Freya. happy swinging birthday for Derek. I'll have your ties if you don't want them.
No.
Get the scissors.
Because he doesn't wear them doesn't mean he's ready to give them away. We have a whole collection, but yeah, it's not going anywhere.
I have a lot of vintage ties.
You do.
And I always say I need to wear more of them. Lisa here, what are you saying? I am loving the music and dancing. I have my three-year-old, excellent, ready to shim sham in his bath. That could make a bit of a splash.
Double splash.
Whilst watching, I reminisce. He says he wants to dance like
the boy.
The boy. Fantastic. So I'm not sure your three-year-old's name, but you just splash around in that bath and do a splash and a splash and a double splash. Excellent. Okay, so what else are we going to talk about today? Well Anna.
Yes. Yes, Simon.
Tell me what you've been up to this week.
Well, I've been up to, we've been pretty busy with V-Day, and it was meant to be the busiest weekend of the year. Before we were in lockdown, we had so many celebrations to be part of. We had several teams ready to entertain. We mentioned Kahoot and the National Army Museum. Of course, all the live events were cancelled, but we still were busy, because a lot of them actually put their events online. So we did we loved joining the National Army Museum for their day, and they had lots happening, history talks and fashion talks. And we, of course, taught the Lambeth Walk and some Jitterbug. But that took just quite a bit of time, because we did all the setup and the sound check and the video check to make sure it didn't get frozen, just like on YouTube at the moment.
And I've got to say, I thought V Day, I don't know about you guys, but I thought it was so special.
It was
such a beautiful day. You know, I love this atmosphere when we all stand outside on a Thursday and applaud the NHS.
Yeah.
It has such a special community feeling, considering we normally don't talk that much to our neighbours.
Yeah.
And now, obviously now we're not talking to them directly, but from a distance we're waving and chatting. And I thought V Day had that same atmosphere.
Friday,
I thought the spirit was beautiful. I have to say, I thought the BBC and all the different things we watched,
the
Queen's speech, I thought were all sublime. Really, it was a lovely special day to commemorate.
And we know some of you have done special things as well on V Day. I know Jane and Derek went full out, entertaining and teaching girls on the streets as well. So well done you. You had even more bouncing than we did.
Excellent. So I see. Katrina says, I watched a documentary about harangue and just knew I had to go there and learn how to dance Lindy Hop. Excellent. So you hadn't been there before. So I'm guessing, Katrina, you're from Sweden. So that was cool. And what's that?
Glenn said that we featured in the paper. Is that for this year or last or another year? Was that for Hyde Park? Did we feature in the paper?
Oh, well, we had a few people inquire and we sent some pictures out, but we don't actually know. So,
well, if you have a picture or if you have the paper, we'd love to see it.
Let us know if there was a picture. That'd be fantastic.
Actually, we had a fairly special V-Day for the 70th year, didn't we?
Yes. I think you've got some pictures.
I have one. I have two pictures. So, 5 years ago for the 70th. If you're on Facebook, I apologise, you can't see the picture. But if you're on YouTube, you can. This is us with the team at on the Paul O'Grady show. Now, that was quite something.
Yeah, he was very nice, Paul, and his guests. And we've actually done that show a couple of times. But this was special because it was VE Day, and he was dressed up in his Navy uniform. We were dancing to Shout and Feel It.
Yes.
And we had a team with us.
A super fast version. They didn't have our normal version because of copyright issues, so they found an older version which was twice as fast. but it was so much fun. I just remember you get to the studio and everyone knows what's happening except for you, and people just move you around from hair and makeup to dressing up to doing this, and at some point you're pushed in and say, okay, you're on, and you're not sure what's happening, but you're in the right place at the right time with the correct hairdo.
Correct hairdo? I don't believe it was the correct hairdo.
Tell
the world the truth. Tell the world
the
truth.
That's true. Yeah, I don't know if... the picture that I posted is a little bit blurry because it's a screenshot from YouTube, actually. Because it's all short of time and it's all so intense when you get there, they had prepared our hair in advance. And what I mean is they prepared the wigs for the girls. the boys are luckier. Now, I'm not sure how they trained in 1940s vintage hairdos, but I thought my hair looked more like Marie Antoinette. It was an interesting look. I don't know about authentic, but it was a fun experience.
It was fun, yeah. Okay, I think it's time for some more music. I think it's time for some more music. Okay, so you've heard us chat for enough. Let's have another album. This one's called Big Band Jazz from Joe Davis, 1940 to 1952. And this is Sugar Foot Stomp, which so happens to be the name of our performance group, the Sugarfoot Stompers. So any of you remember the Sugarfoot Stompers? They don't do much these days. Semi-retirement. Right, Sugarfoot Stomp, hopefully. Oh, it's a bit of a crackly one, isn't it? That's the problem with records. Actually, this is not Sugarfoot Stomp. This is the track before. So I'm just going to move it on a little bit. It's a bit better, isn't it? Now you know why I gave up playing records. This time we'd like to play a couple of up-tempo songs for all of you who like to speed things up a little bit. So here's one. It's not too up-tempo, but it's quite a nice one. It's Chattanooga Choo Choo Boy, Freddie Cannon. Now, I saw another message from Anne who said that she actually recommended Kit Packham for the 100 Club when we booked them. So maybe she was on a commission, I don't know. And we've got some new people watching us as well. We've got Josephine.
Josephine, hello. And Glenn says kindly that he will send us that article. That'd be great.
Ah, fantastic. Right.
And Emma has joined us from Rutland. She loves a Union Jack outfit. Well, I don't get to wear it too often, so I thought I'd make the most of this weekend.
So we thought we'd have our party. So tea at the ready, and I see Anna's got the biscuits.
Are there any left? They're on your side.
They're on my side. They won't be there for much longer. That's all I know. Okay, now I want to know who has been doing my 66-day dance challenge. So I like doing a lot of self-development these days, just because I think it's time I learned something. And I was reading a book.
Never too late.
Well, I hope not. Anyway, I was reading a book by a guy called Gary Keller called The One Thing.
I thought you were going to say Gary Cooper.
Gary Cooper, yeah.
Super duper.
No, Gary Cooper. No, Gary Keller. And he did a thing called the 66-Day Challenge. And I've been ticking it off. So I'm a third of the way through my 66 days. And my dance challenge, for those that don't know, which is probably not many of you, because I probably tell you every week, is to dance every day for myself. Not to prepare classes, not to rehearse, not for work. This doesn't count. I'm not counting this time. It's really just for me. And do you know what? It's such a beautiful experience. Just dancing for myself. I'm reinvigorating my dancing. I'm learning. It's a chance for me to go back over some old notes and to learn something.
You do it more relaxed as well, because you're not doing it for a purpose.
Yeah.
You sort of, it's okay if you come up with something, a great idea, then brilliant, but if not, it doesn't matter. It's just time for you.
Yeah, so I found it very, very instructive. I've been doing lots of solo dance. Anna's been upstairs maybe working, and I've been passing my dance. It's fantastic, really. I do love it. It's an easy thing for me to do because I'm at home and I love to dance. I don't know about anyone else out there. And if that's the case, maybe you should do this dance challenge as well. The idea is every day, minimum of 10 minutes. Now, of course, I'm finding that I'm doing more than 10 minutes, and that's fine. That's allowed. And I put my little X in the box, and the idea is to build a 66-day chain so it becomes dancing for me, and I work on my dancing. I've been doing this morning. I did a cool exercise, actually. I was practicing dance with a weight, and I was dancing on one foot.
I hope you don't mean me. Sometimes we do dance together.
Yeah, that's true. No, I was dancing. I'm going to ignore that comment. I'm going to carry on. I was dancing on one foot. So what I was essentially doing was balancing and being able to interpret the music. And it's wonderful. And then, funnily enough, I spoke to a cousin of mine in America on Zoom, who is, he is a masseur. He's done it for his whole life. He's retired now, actually. So he knows about the body. And he was saying one of the exercises he does is balancing. Because when you get older, you need, and I am getting older, unfortunately, you do need those little muscles that you use to stabilize. So, and I thought, gosh, I'm ahead of the curve. I'm already practicing my balancing exercises. Wonderful. So, yeah, so that's my 66-day challenge.
What's your best side? What's your better foot?
My best foot? Oh, I'm better on my left foot. In fact, my balance is very good on my left foot. My right foot is all over the place. We've got Sandy.
Hi,
hello, Sandy.
Sandy
Bennett. part of MK Swing. So welcome. Nice to see you.
Milton Keynes, yes.
Milton Keynes Swing Dance. And we've got, oh, Richard Potts. Richard. Gosh, I've known Richard for a very long time. He's probably almost as old as me, but not quite. No, Richard, when did we first meet? It was our Ciroc days. That would be back in the 80s, I believe, unless I'm mistaken. Hopefully I'm not mistaken. No, so Richard, do you remember when we first met dancing? It would have been back in the 80s. Oh, and Scott, in fact, the very person who does all the massage and I said about the balancing is there. Hello, Scott, my cousin from America. Welcome. Howdy, I should say.
How appropriate to have an American join us for this V-Day celebration.
Yes, yes. You notice we do have an American flag.
Oh, we do have the tie.
It's an American tie. I didn't have a flag, unfortunately. It's the best we could muster at this short notice. And you've got to remember, everything's rationed.
What do you mean short notice? It was always...
Yes, okay. Right, I think it's time for another song. Mm-hmm. We're going to play another one that you can be a little bit more up-tempo. And we haven't had any...
any questions?
Enough
any requests?
English. So, well, we sorry. I'm requesting one. Okay, thanks.
Too much tea.
too much tea. One, two, button your shoe. This is an English band because I thought it's V Day. We've got to have some English swing bands. Okay, maybe they can't swing like the Americans. I agree, but these guys aren't bad. They could, you know, they could go places. Jack Hilton. If you're a Jack Hilton fan, this is for you. One, two, button my shoe. Button your shoe. Jack Hilton. Yeah, I like a little bit of Jack Hilton now and then. That was fun, that was fun. Anne says she was a regular at Monday Night Stomping. What's that? Emma in Rutland, love your Union Jack outfit. Anna. Anna, yes. She does it again. Another stunning outfit.
And Sandy is asking about your ukulele career.
Oh, yes. I actually haven't played the ukulele for a little while. Yeah. Do you know what? In this lockdown, I thought, my gosh, I'm going to have hours and hours to spare, and I'm going to learn French and play the ukulele, and neither is really happening. So
How about singing in French on the ukulele?
It's not bad, actually. Two birds with one stone. I should do that. Okay, let's see what else we've got coming up. Now, we also have tip of the day. So I've got a swing tip of the day for you, for all you dancers out there, which is play. Questions. If you want to make your dancing exciting, ask questions. Now, what I mean by that is don't just do the same old steps that you learn in class. Those are great steps. The teacher's taught you good stuff. But what they're trying to do is they're trying to open a door for you, and they're trying to give you access to a whole world. And you need to think, how can I take the step and play with it? What can I do to be creative? Ask questions. Think, okay, I did this with the left arm. Can I do it with the right arm? Think, oh, Fiona, hello, Fiona. Fiona is the lovely singer with the Herb Miller Orchestra, John Miller Big Band. I haven't seen you for a little while, Fiona, but great to see you, fantastic. She actually lives not too far from here. So no doubt when we pass by Sainsbury's, we might hear you singing or something, I don't know. And then we've got Richard Badu. Now, he can play the guitar very well. I remember that because he was a bit of an instrumentalist. Can you play the ukulele, Richard? That's what we want to know, because Sandy's reminding me that I played the ukulele.
Played with you, Sandy.
Yes. I wish I played. I enjoyed it, though. It is really good fun to play an instrument.
Hmm. Maybe
next week I'll dig it out and see if I can dust off the odd tune. Right. So what was I saying? I've forgotten
the
now.
Tip.
Oh, yes. Tip
play,
of the week.
Play. Ask questions.
So ask questions. Be creative. Don't just go for the bog standard. Oh, I learnt it this way. That's the only way to do it. Think, what can I do to make it interesting? Sometimes you can give yourself a character. Sometimes you can say, well, what happens if I just focus on one arm? Or sometimes you'll say, okay, I'm going to tune in and listen to the rhythm section of the band, or I'm going to listen to the vocalist, or I'm going to listen to, you know, and you pick out something in the band and you try and focus on that. So ask yourself questions when you're dancing. Questions. The better questions you ask, the better dancer you'll become. Think, how can I improve? What can I practice? That's my tip of the day. Have you got a tip for us, Anna?
I've got it on the tip of my tongue. Yes, I've got a tip. It's a quick one, actually. It's chin up. When you dance, very often when we dance, we're focused on the music, maybe really enjoying ourselves, or focused on our feet and not falling over. But very often we're sort of looking down, and the neck is sort of looking down. Just remember to tip your chin up, or you can think of pushing the neck backwards, and this will really change your posture and make your dancing look like it feels. It might feel great, but if you just look up a little bit, it will also look great.
Yeah, I'm guilty of that. I often get really into what I'm doing and my head goes down and I'm really concentrating, and then I forget to concentrate on my partner. Mm-hmm. And so if you look up, you tend to look at your partner. Now, I just also remembered, Fiona's a really good tap dancer, aren't you, Fiona? So we were talking about tap earlier, saying that I did a little bit with Rusty, if you remember that, in the show, because that was in the show you were in. So,
And Richard says that you can uke a bit.
Ah, fantastic. So, yeah. Yes, all those talented people.
A uke gang on Facebook at the moment.
So many talented people. Mm. Right, how are we doing for time?
We've got half an hour to go left.
Okay.
But we haven't even mentioned dancing for V-Day. What about dancing on V-Day?
Oh, yes, you've got some pictures. If you're on YouTube.
I just have a few. Yeah, if you're on YouTube, you'll be able to see a few pictures. Why are we celebrating V-Day as dancers? Because dancing was such a big part, not only of the celebrations, but also during the war, to keep the morale. It was one way to just escape from every day and keep having something to look forward to and forget about the hardships of everyday life. And so dancing was really, really important. And of course, on V-Day and during the celebration, dancing was very present. The Lambeth Walk, the Hokey Cokey, Knees at Mather Brown.
I thought it was also quite interesting that a lot of the dances, the ones you were just talking about, did you mention the Palais Glide?
Oh, I didn't mention the Palais Glide.
Or the Blackout Stroll?
The Blackout Stroll, I forgot that one.
Yeah, I forgot that one. Well, I couldn't see it really. I could never see it to do it, to be honest. The Blackout Stroll. And which other ones did you mention? Did you mention Knees Up Mother Brown?
Knees Up Mother Brown.
It's a bit naughty, that one,
that's
isn't it?
That's a bit naughty.
You know, showing you lifting your skirt up a bit too high here. Yeah. Bumps a Daisy. Oh, outrageous, outrageous. And mind you, I do like a bit of conga.
Oh, yes, the conga. Do you know the conga?
Actually, our friend Lance Beneshek, he taught us the partnered conga. And we never realised. I always thought it was a dance you did in a line. Mm-hmm. But in fact, it's a really cool partner dance.
Yeah.
Very big around 1938. Had a bit of a vogue. And maybe we should dig out our conga
and
teach
it
1 week.
Partner conga. Yeah. Would you like some partner conga?
Let us
know.
There's
more to the conga that you know.
There's more to the conga than meets the meets the eye. Okay, so I think what's fascinating about what you were saying, Anna, was World War One. Nobody thinks of dancing.
No.
World War One was the trenches, the hardship, the and that's what people associate with World War One. Whereas with World War Two, we all associate the Americans coming over, the Coca-Cola, the chewing gum, the chocolate, the nylons, and we have a different the way we look back at it. I mean, you don't look back at past wars, even you know, the Napoleonic Wars. You know, they you look back on them and you see different things.
Yeah.
But for World War Two, we often think about the dancing, and I think for a lot of people that I spoke to at that time, dancing was their, as you said, was their escapism.
Yeah. Actually, there were you always say there's two main types of entertainment during World War Two. It was dancing
and going
cinema.
To the cinema.
And actually, by going to the cinema, they learned how to dance, didn't they? Especially the Lindy Hop, because they would see clips from Pathé, and they would show short clips of, I don't know, White is Lindy Hoppers, perhaps.
Yeah, yeah,
or
Pathé, you mean Pathé News? Pathé, so they'd be show clips of what was happening in America, the dancing, or you'd see movies like Dare at the Races or Hells of Poppin', but actually in lots and lots of different moves. I'm just reading this. What does Richard
That's
say?
That's why you're distracted.
Yeah.
I was just a chance that I came in for a break from gardening and saw your broadcast and was surprised to hear you mention my name as soon as I tuned in. It's back to digging.
back to digging.
Well, it's quite late. He's in America?
He's in America.
Oh, right, that's why. Because too dark to dig.
Is it Carolina?
If you want to
Carolina?
Finish your plants, we've got some...
Oh, and we've got a ton of compost sitting in the lounge because it
that
got
we
delivered.
Need. We need every bit of it.
And somebody's going to have to take it to the garden. I'm not sure who.
Well, I've got a good friend.
Just as I thought. Anyway... time for a bit more music.
Yes,
Let's have a look at what we've got next. Okay, we haven't had the Harlem Kiddies, and Do You Want to Jump Children? Maybe good for a little bit of Balboa.
Thank you.
Oh, we had a little interruption to our Facebook. Probably because we've been playing too much music and they don't like it. So they cut us off. Every so often, practice standard steps, moves, rhythms, etc.? Oh my gosh, yes. Okay, Derek has asked a very, very good question. Hello, welcome back, Facebook.
Hello, hello. Hope you've
Derek has asked the question, every so often, do you practice standard steps, moves, rhythms, etc.? The answer is yes. Absolutely. It's the scales.
Yeah.
You have to do it over and over, and then over and over, and then over and over.
Again.
So, yes, the answer is. It's quite nice when you... when you practice the basics, you need to be able to fall back into them. And you, when you go off the basic to try some variation, you need to know where you are. Mm. It's like when I first started dancing, I wasn't so familiar with swing music and I had to think about the music. Now I hope I'm a little bit more used to it. So you just start to hear... You would hope so. You start to hear the phrasing. I don't count myself a musician by any means. Yeah, you know, I'm not...
Even through your ukulele career.
Even through my ukulele career. I mean, dancers can be musicians. Definitely should be musicians. And in one sense, especially I suppose, especially tap dancers, but also swing dancers, because you're interpreting the music and you give it a flavour. And I always say when you watch good dancing, you're really hearing the music differently when you watch good dancing. And now, interesting, I did an interview with a musician, and I actually can't think which musician it was. I have to look at my notes. But he actually said that when they play and there are dancers, it brings the music alive. I think it was Pete Long was saying how when he watches dancers, it changes how they play. And the first time he played for a really big dance of serious dancers, he said all the musicians stepped up their game because they were almost playing in step with the feet of the dancers. And I thought that was really cool. Okay, have we got people back?
People joining us again on Facebook. I think we've got people who jumped from the last live and also some new people. So welcome. Welcome to our Swinger Suite Online, our weekly Monday party. Today is V-Day Street Party. And we've got Yeva has joined us. Hi, Yeva. And Yanina as well. Steve, Lucian, back, Chris as well.
Okay, now, I think we should do something that we did last week.
Oh, yes.
Now,
actually, can I give a little bit of back...
Yes, you can.
A little bit of visual background for those who are on Facebook. Because I believe that's what we're
going to do. On Facebook or on YouTube?
On YouTube, sorry, is what I meant. So a couple of pictures should be coming up any time now.
Right. Can you see the pictures? And do you know what they are?
If you're on YouTube, sorry, if you're on Facebook, we'll comment on them in a second.
We will describe them for you in detail if you are on Facebook. The pictures, how would you describe them, Anna?
Well, they are vintage pictures from the 40s. And you can see a lot of people with their thumbs in the air. Now, what do you think they might be doing with
Were they by any chance throwing it over their shoulder?
I think so.
And were they shouting and making a noise at the same time?
I think I've heard oi from the pictures.
Okay. They were going one, two, three, oi. Now, do you know what dance we're about to do? I think you do. It's the Lambeth Walk. So come on, you know Lambeth, that's the way to do it. Because down Lambeth, we know how to treat them. Ready? We take our thumb, we put our nose in the air, and we shout, oi, one, two, three,
oi.
No, I couldn't hear you. You're on the yellow sofa. I can see you. Let's hear that oi, thumb in the air. Put the tea down. Oh, gosh, you nearly choked on it. Oh, dear. Right, ready? One, two, three,
oi.
Excellent. So that is the dance called the Lambeth Walk. Well, there's a little bit more to it. We're going to do it for you. Copy us. We'll do it facing the back so you can copy us, and then we'll turn around halfway through. Right, boys and girls, ladies and gents, haven't left anyone out, have I?
Torino, Italia. Hello, hello. Well, join us just in time for a very Torino. British experience. Torino.
Torino. That's not the Torino who...
Torino with a T.
Oh, Torino. I do apologise.
Torino.
Torino, welcome, welcome.
Yes.
We've got some more people joining us.
All the internationals, this is a very English dance.
Yes. David's watching. Hello, David. You might know this one, the Lambeth Walk. Right, here we go.
Everybody join in.
Thumbs in your braces. If you ain't got braces, do you want to just lift your braces? If you ain't got braces, brass jacks will do.
Lambert, you're good at the theme.
Check the neat's working.
We haven't got
nose in the air.
Touch, but that don't
matter. And a little swagger.
We play a different way. Not like you, but a bit more.
Turn around,
if we have a little fun.
All
right.
All together.
Anytime you're Lambert way. Any evening.
Arm in arm. Arm and spam.
Mind that all. Doing the Lambert walk.
Forward,
if
forward.
The Lambert cow. Takes along a Lambert
cow. That's it, very appealing. Let's hear it. Doing the Lambert walk. Aye.
If it is that easy, to add it on well please. Why don't you make your way there? Stay there.
Aye, I think she's got it.
Once you get down that way, any evening, any day, you'll find
your way. Doing the Lambert walk. Aye. Love it, that's. We're doing it. Here we go. All together. Doing the Lambert walk.
Oi! Everything's right and pretty. To add to that well pretty. Why don't you make your way there? Go there. Stay there. Once you get down Lambert way. Any day, you'll find your way.
Doing the Lambert. One more time.
Oi!
Lambeth Walk. Aye. That was a true English experience, the Lambeth Walk. Lupino Lane, 1937, revived in 1944. That was the show to do, that was the show to be at. Right, have we got anyone else? Eustace, oh no, Ingrid. Ingrid? And I misread that. You know,
not
I need,
even close.
I need my glasses. What have we got this? I
got
saw
Emma, who saw us on the newspaper as well. It might be the same newspaper as Glenn. Who knows?
Well, if not, if you could send us, if you could scan it and send it to us, that'd be brilliant.
Watching.
Mo, happy birthday, Mo. Woo!
Happy birthday.
Woo! Mo, one of the best dancers in the world.
Whoa.
One of the best Lindy Hoppers. Fantastic. Lovely to see you, Mo. Mwah, mwah, mwah. And I know it's her birthday, so a very special occasion. Unfortunately, you missed the birthday jam, Mo. You have to come earlier next time.
Can we play a song for Mo?
But have
dedicate
a
song.
Okay, let's have a look. Let's see what we can dedicate
well,
a song for
Mo. You mentioned that Duke Ellington did the Lambeth Walk. Did you have that queued up, or
well,
am I putting you on the spot?
I don't have it queued up, but
you I'm
keep talking,
you
Anna, and I will find it.
Well, that's the end of my knowledge on the Lambeth Walk, but what I can do is show you, tell you, no, what can I say about the Lambeth Walk? We've
know.
Been teaching it all weekend, but I'm all Lambeth walked out.
Yes, okay. So who was doing the Lambeth Walk? That's what I want to know. Okay, I've got a version that I'm going to play by Artie Shaw, because it's actually quite a good dancer, this one. So this one is for Mo, because I know you know how to do the Lambeth Walk. One, two, three.
Oi.
Right. This is a nice dancey version of the Lambeth Walk by Mr. Artie Shaw. Thank you. Are you warmed up now? Hopefully, oh, let's put this this back over here. Right, so who have we got? Oh, we've got Lucianne, fantastic. Lucianne, and I hope the whole family dancing. M. Lou is watching. Lucianne Wolf, sending sunshine to you from both. Lovely to see you dancing. Yay! Thank you, thank you. Kit Packham, gather you have mentioned me. Yes, we have indeed, Kit. Great to see you keeping things going online. Well, we're doing our best. Missing all my gigs, aren't we all? And all my dancing, but still smiling. That's the important thing. The question is, what have you been doing while you've been in lockdown? Have you been taking advantage and sitting on the sofa, eating lots of cakes and drinking lots of beer? Or have you been learning something? Well, I've been doing both really. No, actually, I have, as I say, I've been practicing me dancing, and that's quite good fun. I have enjoyed that. Right, we're coming now near to the end. How have we got? So normally at this point, we play something a little bit slower and cozier. So I'm going to get that ready for all of you who like to slow things down. Actually, but before that, I think I'm going to play something a little bit different. This one is another English, as it's a V-Day dance, I'm going to play something English for you. I have another English band. This one is called Ambrose, and it's called The Love Bug Will Bite Ya. Here we go, Ambrose. We're going very English today.
Then you'll sing and shout. Dee 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 dee. That's what love is all about.
Yeah, well, we had to play a few English bands today, I thought, to we've had Harry Roy Ambrose and a few others. We had to be a little bit English, didn't we? And Cheryl, my other cousin in America, is watching. Woo! Hello, welcome, welcome.
America.
Fantastic. Yeah, I guess it's a good time for America. Yeah. Chris Clark is watching. Welcome. Andrea Siebeck. Ah, guten Tag. Yeah, very British. Well, I've always wondered, when we drink tea, why we put the little finger up. And I'm sure many of you have wondered, but I actually found it's... I'm going to do it with this hand. It's quite good for raising a glass because it's sort of a good lever, so very handy. And I've got my special celebratory mug for the occasion.
Fantastic. Right. So we've had quite an international crowd today.
We're
coming to the end, and this is when we slow things down and you get a little bit cozy. So cozy up to the cat, to the dog, the hamster, the tortoise, whatever you want to cozy up to, your partner, and we're going to play a little Nat King Cole.
Well, just for those who are joining us at the towards the end of the show, we're here every Monday. We have a two-hour show every Monday night with lots of dancing, lots of music, lots of chit-chat. You can ask questions, you can say hello to each other. Really good fun.
Yep. We're primarily on YouTube for all you Facebook people. But it's great that you're here. I see Jamie, my cousin. Hey, hello, Jamie. He's on the front line being a doctor. He's been sorting out all this coronavirus and solving it for everyone. And Michelle from France, Michelle Plonger, a teacher from Toulouse.
Yes,
welcome. Nice to see you.
Bonjour.
Bonsoir. Lady Lynn Forbes, welcome. All joining us at the last moment, but joining us, and that's the main thing. Oh, what's this?
Florence and Jim are on day 22 of the challenge. Excellent.
Wow,
One third in.
Same as me. I did print up from theonething.com, which is where I got the idea to do the challenge.
Oh, and Cheryl says her mom used to dance to Ambrose.
Nice. So,
if you have anecdotes of your parents dancing, grandparents dancing, yourself, in the first time round of the Jitterbug or that era, vintage era, do let us know. We love those stories.
Okay, well, right. We're going to leave you with a little bit of Nat King Cole and followed actually by a bit of Al Boley afterwards. So if you're hanging around for a bit of Al Boley, you've got to get through the Nat King Cole first, but hopefully not too torturous. Let me see if I put that one on. So, Frim, Fram. Thank you very much, by the way, everyone, for showing up today. We've really had a great party today.
Yeah.
I think this has been a really fun one. Yeah. We've had such an international crowd. Marvellous. we talked all sorts of things. If you don't know, Anna does a daily jazzalation. It's free. It's on YouTube. And you can get a quick 5-minute burst of some jazz steps to copy. We've also got some beginners classes, some intermediate classes on YouTube. And we're putting more stuff up all the time. My swing notes back copies are out, so do check out the swing notes. There's 176 at the moment, aren't I, or something? I forget. But anyway,
stop counting.
And there's Anjali. Hello, welcome again. Fantastic.
Hello.
Right, Frim Fram Sauce. That's what we promised you. Nat King Cole. Here it goes.
Coming.
Thank you. fella really got me. And a fella should eat right. Five will get you ten. I'm gonna feed myself right tonight. I don't want fish cakes, rye bread. You heard what I said. Waiter, please serve my bride. I want them brown sauce with the awesome thing, with shellfire on the side. Now if you don't have it, just bring me a check for the water.
Thank you so much, everybody. We've come to the end. We will see you next week. We will see you next week. Oops, what?
We will see you next week.
Oh, a perfect show until the end. I haven't got a record to play you, but hopefully I have got. I did promise you a little bit of Al Bowley to play you out, and I've actually lost that music now. I think I hit the wrong button. Let me find Mr. Al Bowley for you. There he is. Okay. Just before I play it, is there anything left to say? Send us some comments. We're going to do a poll. We're going to find out. So do check the Facebook group. What you want in future shows. Do you want more chat? Do you want more music? Do you want more instruction? Do you want more dancing? Do you want more Balboa, more shag? Let us know. What you want. If you've got questions, history about the scene, maybe I'd love to do some interviews. We tried one and it froze the whole thing. But we have been doing lots of interviews on Swing Notes. So check those out. You can get them for free. Just sign up to our mailing list and sign up for Swing Notes. We've got some, it comes out every Sunday. Okay, good night, sweetheart, is all that's left to say. So it's good night from me, Simon.
And it's good night from me, Anna.